In this presentation, we will also show how to generate solids of revolution like this, and especially dynamically. We will see also how to generate their corresponding Riemann cylinders like this in order to approximate the volume of such solid with the sum of the volumes of such Riemann cylinders. Let us see what we want to show exactly with a figure I've created with Cabri 2+, but later we will see how to present the same thing with TI N-Spire. What we want to do is to show such a solid and how to create it, starting from the initial curve, which is the quadratic function shown in blue here, rotating here around the x-axis and getting this solid of revolution. So we want to evaluate the volume of such a solid to approximate it, and the idea is this one. If we rotate like this, we generate the previous solid. But in order to generate an approximation of this solid, we will create first, as we did before, the piecewise function associated to this function and to this subdivision with 12 intervals, and we'll rotate around a circle, and if we rotate like this, we rotate like this to generate another solid, and this solid, let us hide that first, and this solid is this one. Obtained with two loci. One is the loci of the piecewise function rotating around the x-axis, and the other one is the locus of the previous circle when x moves along AB. And you can see if I change the value of n, increasing the value of n, all these cylinders are approaching the solid we have shown at the beginning. Let us rotate here to see better. So later we will show what we propose to do with TI N-Spire to do such animation and such dynamic presentations.